true or not, sees Bob.
Disappoint me. As you know, I am not easily entertained. I assure you, Highness, tonight you will see all manner of surprising scenes played out before your very eyes. Why, see here, the Honorable Bunigana Thundertontrop, late of Westphalia, now, reluctantly, a kept woman.
Very well.
Thank you.
My dear ladies, allow me to introduce you to our gracious host, Prince Alexander Pietro Niklaus Orlovsky. Your Highness, this is Signora Norina Pasquale. She is something of an actress.
Signora, piacere di conoscere.
And this is my dear friend Adele, Your Highness. She is...
Well, I'm something of an actress too, Your Highness. Well, I hope to become an actress. It takes a lot of luck.
I am very fond of actresses. And of luck. Let us try yours now. Would you ladies be so kind to take my wallet and play it roulette for me?
With pleasure.
But what if we lose? Then I shall have the pleasure of seeing you again very soon.
So, what do you think of the prince?
He seems pretty charming.
My dear father, how does that enchanting creature fit into your plan?
Your Highness, I think it will not give away the surprise if I tell you that Mademoiselle Adele is no actress. She is the maid to our hero. Wow, and there he is now, the unwitting hero to our little drama. That is my dear friend, Herr Gabriel von Eichenstein, pretending to be the French Marquis de Bernard. He is supposed to report to jail tonight, struck a police officer. But I convinced him to stop by for one last night of revelry before his sentence begins. My dear Marquis, allow me to introduce you to our host, Prince Alexander Orlovsky.
It is a great honor to meet your highness.
He likes your fancy watch.
Mercy.
My dear Marquis, you must have a drink with me and allow me to acquaint you with the rule of my villa.
Rule? Does your highness mean rules?
Oh no, my dear Marquis. I have only one.
Yes!
is what wife's made.
Marquis! This is Mademoiselle Adele. She is an aspiring actress. Mademoiselle, may I present Marquis Lelanade.
Mademoiselle, you forgive me. You look remarkably like my wife's maid.
You forgive me, Marquis, for you yourself remind me very much of a certain gentleman who is often seen at the theater flirting with the chorus girls.
And your dress reminds me very much of my wife's newest ball gown.
I was down on a matter of urgent business.
No matter.
you'll be pleased to find a fellow countryman here.
Monsieur le Chevalier Chagrin, Monsieur le Marquis de Lanalle.
Enchanté. Souffle.
J'ai l'honneur.
I want to walk.
Oh, parlez français.
Si vous voulez.
I think the two of you will become intimate acquaintances in very short order.
Dinner is served.
Oh, Monsieur le Marquis, please be so kind to take Mademoiselle Modell on your arm. My friends, let us go in.
Ow!
Who can say, Your Highness? Perhaps they will do both.
Have you ever seen so many beautiful women in your life? Each one more gorgeous than the last.
Gorgeous indeed, but I have eyes only for my darling Cunegonde. My Norina is both beautiful and clever. But what good will it do me if my uncle will not let me wed her?
Matcha loves my poetry.
And then there's Mimi
and Violeta.
I can't make up my mind.
There's just something so hot about a Parisian girl who coughs like that.
I feel like I'm being pulled in all different directions. Almost as if my very personality were being split into three parts.
I know just what you mean.
I have the greatest affection for my former comrades, the pirates. And yet, as a slave of duty, I have no choice but to devote myself to their complete extermination.
And I have allowed my beloved to enter a mock marriage with my uncle.
What?
In order to get her to trick him into letting her marry me.
Dude.
How is it that I'm the only one here that isn't completely screwed up?
Isn't your girlfriend currently employed as a mistress to not one, but two men?
Thank you. We take off our shoes and stockings and paddle. Blushing birds of ever-blooming beauty.
Thank you. Oh!